Yeah, another vlog of Daily Dump. I'm feeling more comfortable today speaking in front of the camera while walking on the street, you know, and yeah, more comfortable. So today, basically, I did a leap into clarity. I went to uni and, you know, I was kind of stressed out because I was falling behind in my uni work and I haven't submitted assignments from my first term. And because of that, I was kind of stressed, so I booked an appointment with one of my head teachers. And I spoke to him and he was like, don't worry, you're not gonna get kicked out of the university, you're just gonna be capped at 40%, which is passed basically, which for me, which I'm very happy about. So that means I fucked up once and that's it. That should be like a lesson. That should be something like I need to make sure that next year I don't do anything like that, and I'm very prepared, and I'm very prepared. And yeah, look at this. Such a great view, isn't it? Yeah, and my fighting against smoking cigarettes still going on. I've smoked 2 cigarettes today. I think actually 3. And I'll try to stay away from it. Well, the craving kicks in all the time, but you know, I'm fighting against it. Also, one of the weaknesses I need to fight against is my spending money wisely, you know. And I need to learn how to spend my money wisely and how to, like, oh, look at those flowers. Look at those flowers. So, yeah. What are they doing? Yeah. No, so basically, yeah. And I was just thinking, like, I need to get myself like a plan, you know? I need to get myself a plan of action, like a clear plan of actions, like what do I have to do and what do I have to I think I'm like confusing. So basically I need a clear plan, like what I have to do, a clear plan of actions, to have more clarity of what I'm doing and to just do it, basically do it and do not procrastinate and just fucking try my best to do it and do not leave it till the last minute like I used to do. Also, I think the most of the stuff, a lot of my problems that I have right now is because I was living everything for the last moment, you know. So because I was living everything for the last moment and I didn't take the actual step into like getting into the discomfort and study when I have to study and not put it aside. And because I did that, because I wasn't disciplined, that's why everything happened what it happened, you know. But now it's like, now I have a better vision. I feel like I woke up. I faced some difficulties, you know, but these difficulties basically made me basically reassess my life and refocus, you know. It was like a wake up call. And I'm very happy, to be honest. I'm very happy where I'm now. I'm very grateful that I'm not gonna get kicked out of the uni, and I still can do it, you know. And I still can, submit my assignments and still go on into the next year. And yeah, I'm feeling more confident about what I'm doing. I have a better vision, but I still have to make a better plan. Today I've got a job interview and let's see how it's gonna go. To be honest, I'm not very happy about the job that I have to work a job, you know, because I wanted to invest all my time into social media, but unfortunately I have to find myself a job that will help me to survive for a little bit. And yeah, the biggest lesson that I've learned from this whole is that I have to always have a vision, always know what I'm doing if I'm feeling lost. I have to find my way back as soon as possible. And like, always reevaluate my values, always rethink, meditate, think, am I on the right way? Am I doing the right thing? Am I moving towards my goal, or am I deviating from it? Yeah. One of the progresses that I can say, one of the progresses that I've made, is that I'm feeling better talking in front of the camera in public, you know, because in the past I used to be very like shy about it, but now I don't give a fuck, you know, like I'm feeling quite confident about it. And yeah, my personality grows, my speaking abilities are become better, everything becomes better, basically everything becomes better now because I have a better vision. And you know, all these challenges that I have that I had just basically helped me to refocus and made me like a stronger person, basically. So now I have to think about that will relate to you, right? Now I think I have to also don't make it about myself. I have to speak about something that will resonate with you guys. And right now I don't know what can I say to resonate with you. Unfortunately, I only knew how to talk about myself in this vlog, but I would like you to write in the comments, please, what was the highlight of your day, and what are you trying to become in 5 years? You know, that's the thing. Have I said everything? Well, I'm growing. What can I say? 420 subscribers already. I'm growing. My channel is becoming bigger. Oh, well, by the way, one big thing that I did today, one big thing, is I've sat down with one of my friends, Jive the Hardest, and me and him, we planted the seed of our collaboration, you know? We made a plan about how we're gonna make money. So first of all, we're gonna make a video together. So at the moment I have to get like credits, you know, like credits, something that other people will, for example, will watch me and be like, oh, this guy is, we can take him seriously, you know, we can make something out of this, you know. And yeah, so I need like strong credentials, so a strong personality on YouTube, and I have to build that right now. I have to build my reputation as a YouTuber. But I feel like a rock star already, so it should be easy money for me, easy job. I was saying that I spoke to him and we made a plan together, like we're gonna do affiliate marketing together, but first we're gonna do a collaboration. So me and him, we're gonna make a video together, and I'm gonna talk about him. And honestly, this is one of my biggest projects on YouTube so far, which I think you will enjoy it, because he is such a, he's got like a quite big personality, a big portfolio in rap, music, script. So he's done rapping, he does script writing, he writes a book, he does directing, he's studying media. So, and you'll find more about him in my next video, which is gonna be amazing, because I'm preparing for it, I'm taking it very seriously, and I want to make it like a big thing, you know. And yeah, I'm very excited for it. And then when I'll get better credits and I'll be like a bigger YouTuber, then I can step into affiliate marketing. So that's the plan, basically, affiliate marketing. branding. Also, yeah, we plan that we're gonna, you know, we're gonna like make a brand together. And yeah, we're gonna make a brand together. So we basically, we're gonna do some, like, we haven't spoken it like better yet, like how we're gonna make money from affiliate marketing, because he has a brand already that he has a brand already that I have to. So he has already like a company called Drip Gods, right? And I'm thinking me and him we actually gonna make it like a brand together, you know. That's the plan. And also what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna grow as a personality, and I'm gonna improve the way I speak, the way I listen. That's very important, you know. Above all this, like, technology, good camera, you have to have a good personality behind it, you know. I think I think good content comes from your personality. So this is where I am at right now. I don't know what area is it, but it's in London. So I'm here by this beautiful bed of flowers, you know, trying to make some content. This is my bag. I've told you I'm homeless, right? So basically everything, it's in my bag. This series, so I'm launching my series called Broke But Not Broken, where I'll be talking about my surviving in London with basically very small capital. I'll be talking about my survival in London. Surviving in London is easy, you know. If you know how to find your way around, you know what food to buy and where. As I was saying, like, if you know where to go, what to buy and stuff like that, then it'd be easy for you to survive. But you just basically have to be smart. I'm gonna show you what food I bought today. I've spent £5 something on this one. So this is orange juice, which is like £1 something, £1.20 max. Then I have like this one, which is like 52 pence. It was in the reduced section. You know the reduced section in Tesco? So if you go to Tesco, there's a reduced section where they get rid of all the products that's gonna go off, you know, soon. So they reduce the price so they can sell it. So I bought this from the reduced section. And then I bought some like chicken, barbecue chicken breast pieces, which is £1.52. Yeah, like this. And I bought this fucking huge sunblushed tomato and garlic flatbread, which is 72 pence. So you see, all that's actually a lot of food, you know. All that costs me like £5, and it's gonna be enough for this time, and I'm gonna have some leftovers for the evening as well. So, but first, what I wanted to do, I wanted to buy some chicken drumsticks, but they cost like £3 something, and they don't have as much, how do I say it? They don't have as much, like, you know what, I'm thinking maybe I should have bought the, when I make the math right now, maybe I should have bought the chicken drumsticks. The fuck? Wait, three? Nah, I think this one was better. I think this one was cheaper and it's gonna last me for longer. I think if I bought the chicken drumsticks, it wouldn't last me for a long time. So this is better because I can make two meals out of it. So yeah. You know what, because I was thinking, if I bought the chicken drumsticks for like £3 something and this juice, it would have been the same price of all of it. But you see here, you have like different types of food. So you have like carrots, you have like flatbread, you have this. So I think this is better. I don't know. Basically, guys, text me in the comments. When you go to Tesco, right, what do you go for? Like, what cheap stuff you go for? Give me some suggestions as well. Give me some suggestions. I would like help from you guys. Where to buy the cheapest, where to go to buy the cheapest food, what places should I go and visit, and stuff like that. Yeah. This is the series Broken Not Broken by Moldavite. And yeah. I have nothing else to say. Bambini, carrot, carrot, bambino. Eat healthy. For a dick to grow big. Yeah, this is the shard. It looks like a big antenna, you know. Yeah, I'm going to my job, my first trial shift. Hopefully it's gonna go well. A fucking kitchen in a bus. Look at that. Wow, that's the first time I see that in my life, you know. I just finished my trial shift. So you can see it's a very private atmosphere. It's a very like, it's in the basement, right? And it's in the basement, a very private atmosphere, very, you know, very calm vibes. It's a cocktail bar. You can see the bar over here. And the main man, the boss man as well, making cocktails. Yeah. I like this concept, you know. It's very, you can come here with your girlfriend or with maybe like a business partner, you know, to have a business chat or like intimate chat, and no one will hear it, so. Yo, look how beautiful it looks here. See the cherry trees? I'm not sure if that's a cherry tree, but yeah, the tree blossoming looks very good. And I like this street, you know, look at this. Yeah. It looks amazing. Yeah, it's a great place to come here. It's a great place to come here and walk, you know. I need to get out of the way. I love the bikes though, look at them, they're so shiny. Yeah, big city life. Busman is waiting for the girls to hop in. I think there's someone dancing over there. Alright, let me go and see what's going on over there. Gotta be careful though. Alright, we're getting close enough. Alright, let me see what's going on. Oh shit! Hey, I came right at the end. Alright. Let's see what's going on. Let's see what kind of motion is going on here. Alright. Oh, Come on. Yeah. Yeah. Oh. Damn. Damn. All right. Buckle up. Oh yeah, oh yeah, he's warming up, come on. Hey! Hey! Yalla, yalla, yalla. Mama. Oh yeah. She's doing the thing, I don't know what she's doing, but it looks like she knows what she's doing. Oh yeah. All right. Oh yeah. Nice. Come on. Besame. Yeah. Arriva papi. Suavemente besame. Te quiero sentir tus labios besándome otra vez. Suave, besame, suave, besame otra vez. Yo quiero sentir tus labios otra vez. Latino vibes now, Latino vibes, come on. Like, hey, she's just going like. Hey. She doesn't care, she's just doing her thing. Alright, my man steps in. Come on. Nice. Woo, 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 woo. All right, that was good.
That was it for today. I passed my trial shift. The manager said he likes me and he likes my vibe. He likes the way I socialize with people. He likes my how I work, my technique of working. He can say that I worked behind the bar, that I have experience. So yeah, I have a green light, so I've got a job, something that will help me survive for a period of time until I can make money off YouTube. And yeah, the only way is up. Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up. So yeah, the only thing I need to do now is just keep doing what I'm doing and just keep strong. That's what I need to do, and that's what I will do. So yeah, hope you guys have a great time whatever you're doing. Please smash the like and subscribe and show big love into the comments, and you'll be up for some more great videos. I will try to make the best content for you, because I love you, my viewers. You are the reason I am on YouTube. So take care. I will see you very soon. Moldavite.